breakaway group now going under 20 kilometres to go on this descent. You can see she's starting to be a little bit more cautious. Now they start the climb of the Côte de Morais. You can see the change in gradient there. It starts at around 5.3%. There's a steep middle section and then a pretty steady second half of the climb.
Righty, we're really going to see how this breakaway fares over this climb. The riders that have been having a tough day, they won't have anywhere to hide. We will see this group become a little bit smaller by the top.
Former cyclocross world champion leading them up this climb. Still, it's Paladin leading on the descent for the yellow jersey group. And there's Demi Vollering. We haven't seen her at all. Now up into third position, tucked in on the wheel of Elisa Longo Borghini. And look at Kastelijn, climbing specialist. She's decided to attack on this climb out of her breakaway. And the reaction coming from Anushka Costa. She'll be desperate for those 5 points, the maximum points for this Category 2 climb. The other rider on the wheel there is Alicia Zufi from Saradazit. You can see her in the blue and red jersey. And Cordon Rogot chasing down. So that's number 151.
The yellow jersey racing as if there is no tomorrow. And for the second day running, it's Fenix-Deceuninck trying to upset the big favourites. Kastelijn this time. Yesterday it was van der Velde. And they're a chance to get a stage win.
This is fantastic riding from the Fenix-Deceuninck squad. They had two riders in the breakaway, Kastelijn and her teammate Troyan. She is going for the stage win today. That was so close yesterday with van der Velde getting caught with 200 metres to go. They're going to make sure it's not that close today. But this chasing peloton, they are charging along this climb.
Yara Kastelijn now coming across the summit of this Category 2 climb. She's going to be fighting all the way to the finish. A tricky descent. Maximum points now, 5 points for Kastelijn. She's put 47 seconds into the chases now. And remember, this is the longest stage that any of these riders has ever raced over. She's been in the break for 160 kilometers.
And now Costa is trying to hold on for the remaining points at the top of this Category 2 climb. It's the biggest climb of the day. Gutierrez is working her way across. Costa hoping up to pick a few of the minor points. And still in the middle is Cordon Rogot. And this will be important in the race for the polka dot jersey. Costa gets there, and Audrey Cordon Rogot has been caught by the group. She's at the back of the group, so a second over the top for the Dutch woman, Anushka Costa. She's had a good day out.
Well, breakaway lovers' hearts were broken all over the world at stage three. Not today. The tongue is out. She's sucking in as much of that oxygen as she can get. Just 1,300 metres to go.
The 1 kilometre marker. Another acceleration. She continues to descend. It's the last 500 metres that are brutally steep to the finish line in Rodez.
She's choosing the shortest line there. Look at the race time, over 4.5 hours, and they've had some tailwinds. This has been a really long and brutal day.
And that is the yellow jersey group. No, this is the group with Amanda Spratt. They're through at 3 kilometres to go. No, this is the chasing group. They're at 3 kilometres to go. They're a long, long way back. 2 kilometres now for Juliette Labousse.
Well, this has been a good move by Labousse. She's trying to get a jump on other riders contending for general classification. All the seconds will count today, and that uphill finish will make a big difference. Now it's Casper, teammate of Moorman. She's doing all the work. So we have two riders from Movistar, two from SD Works, and two from AG Insurance. Elisa Longo Borghini is here on her own.
Riders spread out all across the roads on the way to Rodez. Kastelijn, former breakaway companions, then Juliette Labousse, then the yellow jersey group. It is so, so steep to the finish line.
It's incredibly steep. Now looking like Labousse's efforts could be neutralized by the strong chase of Romy Kasper. She's not giving up, though.
The barricades are being belted in Rodez. They're getting excited about the arrival of a stage winner going solo. Juliette Labou still trying to hold off the yellow jersey group, looking for some time gains, trying to fight her way back into contention for a top five finish in the overall standings.
Well, the camera focused on a French woman, but as she goes under the Flamme Rouge, we are excitedly waiting at the finish line now for a Dutch woman who might be taking a solo stage and a huge upset for Fenix-Deceuninck.
All she needs to think about now, Yara Kastelijn, is how will she celebrate. She will get there, and she'll get there on her own. This is her former breakaway companions. They are now racing for second, that they might be caught by the yellow jersey group. Emerging from the climb, it is a solo victory, the first win in her career. She's about to burst out in tears and disbelief. It is time to celebrate. It's a downhill run for the final 50. Kastelijn is the queen of Rodez. What a way to get your first ever victory.
Incredible performance by the Dutch climber. She put it back in the big chain ring for the last 100 metres.
And now the sprint is on for second place, and there are time bonuses. The yellow jersey group, they have caught the remnants of the breakaway.
Well, Costa is not waiting for those GC contenders. She wants the points. She wants to get to the line first. This has been a great fight by her.
And it's a long 300 metres. Costa with Lemoel behind her. Then it is Van Vleuten and Vollering. Also fighting back is Uadoma. In the fight is Longo Borghini. Righty, someone from the break. They deserve to hold on for second. Costa is close. Will she make it? It's Vollering who is charging. For Vollering, there are time bonuses for second place and for third place. Costa desperately trying to hold on, but Vollering is going to claw her way over the top to second place on the stage. Vollering in second, Costa in third. Vollering's not sure, because it's a breakaway solo that has won Kastelijn.
I don't think Vollering knew that that break got across the line. She celebrated like someone who might have taken the stage.
She celebrated like somebody that thought she might have, but wasn't 100% convinced. If any team deserved it.
Well, not just a victory for Kastelijn and for Fenix-Deceuninck, but also for Van der Velde yesterday. Well, a roller coaster of emotions, and the family here to be with Kastelijn.
And a huge team performance from SD Works.
Representant les Pays-Bas pour la formation Fenix-Deceuninck, celle qui remporte la quatrième étape, Yara Kastelijn.
Yara Kastelijn, her first ever professional win on the road, and she's picked the biggest stage possible to do so. The winner of stage four at the Tour de France Femmes, Avec Zwift, waving to one of her teammates coming across the finish line. Lotte Kopecky, a massive ride today by Kopecky, a selfless ride by Kopecky.
Yeah, if she's trying to put terror into the hearts and minds of her teammates, competitors, it is working. Because when she attacks, they don't know, is this for real? Should I be chasing? Is she going to be able to maintain this?